How did the song All For Believing come about?
I think I was 15 and I'd written a song about my boyfriend. It was for a music class project. We'd been given the challenge to write our own composition. I hadn't done my homework, so I just went into the music school at recess before the class, and I wrote this song quite quickly, which is kind of amazing to think back on. I got a good grade and the teacher was really impressed. And a few weeks later, a representative from Roland came to the school, and Roland sell keyboards and musical recording equipment, and they were trying to kind of spruik all this equipment to the school, saying, you know, you should really use this with your students. You know, do you have any students that have written their own songs? Maybe we could kind of use them as a guinea pig to show you how the recording equipment works. And so, yeah, my music teacher was like, oh, I have a girl who's written a good song, she might be good. He went back to the Roland headquarters and was like, hey, listen to this really cool song. And they were like, oh, well, we really need a new song for our new keyboards as a demo. So maybe we can ask her if she wants to kind of record the song properly for us and we can put it on our equipment. So I did that, and that was the first kind of proper recording I did. That recording, 2 years later, my sister sent in to Triple J Unearthed.
Yes.
And it won that. So that wouldn't have happened probably if I didn't have this recording from a couple of years before. That was the start of everything.
That procrastinating school assignment led to so much.
Yeah, it's funny the way things happen.
In 2001, in her final year at school, Missy got her first break, an Australian record deal. A year later, while backpacking around Europe, an even bigger opportunity opened up.
When I was overseas, my manager was kind of emailing me saying, hey, it's kind of crazy, but somebody has picked up All For Believing in America and is playing it in Los Angeles on the radio, and it's getting a lot of traction, and there's like four or five major labels that really want to sign you over there.
Wow.
So they want to fly you over there, business class, and they want you to do a showcase. And I was sleeping in flea-ridden hostels at this point, literally all over Europe. But I ended up flying from London over to America to do this showcase for the major labels, and then coming back and continuing backpacking with my mate around Europe. And I ended up signing to Warner Brothers over there. So we did kind of a simultaneous release.
You're 18, 19, you've signed with Warner Brothers and there's all these offers, and what's that like for a young kid?
It was pretty overwhelming. I mean, it happened so fast. I mean, I was just writing songs in my bedroom, and then the next minute, you know, people were playing my song on the radio in America and then wanting to sign me, and I had this dream of singing in front of thousands of people, and at that point I thought, oh my God, maybe this is actually going to come true, you know.
Missy's dream soon became a reality. In 2004, her debut album, The Sound of White, went straight to number one, featuring her hit single, Scar. A year later, she took home 5 ARIA Awards. What's that like to have your whole family there and grandma, and how proud were they?
They were so proud. I think my grandma was the proudest because she was just so stoked to have a camera pointed at her. I remember when I won, she was like, when the cameras were coming towards me, she like sidled up closer to me and she got like right next to me and made sure that I was the first one that she kissed. It was hilarious. Song of the Year was up first, and Ben Lee won that. And David Hasselhoff was presenting, and he went up and he kissed David Hasselhoff on the lips. And I was like, oh, Ben, that was so good. If I win the next one, what am I gonna do? I've got to one-up Ben Lee somehow. So I won Album of the Year, and I was like, right, I'm doing this. And I went up on stage, and I just jumped on him. I just took a leap. And he's really tall. I did not expect him to be that tall. And the first thing that crossed my mind, I was like, oh my God, I think my dress is up above my head. I think the whole world can see my undies. Yeah, it was hilarious. He totally went along with it and went, you know, like that to the crowd. And
awesome.
Yeah, they loved it. And after I got off stage, my manager was like, that was genius, Missy.